Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making ranch beans. And we're going to start with some chorizo. And that is a Mexican sausage. And you'll see I have some in this deep skillet. This is 1/4 pound. So we will be adding some olive oil, just a splash here. And then we will be browning this on the stove. So I'm going to set that on the stove, but I'm not going to brown it right now because I need to turn my attention to something else. In this recipe, we have some chopping to do. We have some vegetables involved, and I thought this would be a good opportunity to introduce you to the Dahlstrong ceramic knife set. And these are the spectral blades that have the V3 technology, and that means they are not only ceramic, but they are very sharp. They stay sharp a long time, but they are easily sharpened. This is the set. It's color-coded, so you can remember the one with the red handle is the chef's knife. And then we have the blue-handled utility knife. We have the pink-handled slicing knife. And then we have the green-handled paring knife. And you can see I'm set up here to slice or chop, actually, an onion, and I'm going to be using my chef's knife. Here's the sheath, so I'm just going to leave that behind, and I'm going to clean this again, and I'll put it there. And moving on, we have a jalapeno pepper here. I think the chef's knife is a little large for that, so I'm going to choose, we could use the chef's knife for all, but here we're using the slicing knife. Now, I have a tomato. I think we'll go back to the chef's knife for that. So I just want you to notice these are beautiful knives. And if you are interested in them, I am going to have a link right below the video in the description of this video. And it will take you to Amazon where you can read the description and you can find out more about the knives and you could purchase them if you want to. So right now, let's go over to the stove and brown up our chorizo. I have browned my sausage, my chorizo, and I've left it on the stove because I need to prepare some vegetables. I'm using the chef knife, and the hold that you use is a pinch hold. So you grab the two sides of the blades with your thumb and your index finger, and then you're ready to slice down if you want this in half, and we need 1/2. So I'm going to be slicing toward the root end. And I choose a position, maybe 3/8 of an inch, something like that. And just go parallel to the counter and cut almost to the end, but it will be held together by the root end. And then I come up another 3/8 of an inch and repeat that. Then I swivel this around and I'm going to be cutting down almost to the end, but I want that held together by the root end, so I'm not going all the way through the root. And then just 1/4 inch, 3/8 inch, whatever size you would like, go all the way to the bottom, keep your fingers out of the way, and that has everything separated so I can swivel this around and then just chop downward. So for my jalapeno pepper, I've chopped off the end here, and then I want to go down the center. And then you notice I have a scoop here. I'm going to use this. I think this is actually a melon baller, and I just want to take out the fibers and the seeds. This is easy with a spoon, but even easier if you have one of these nice scoops. I'm going to keep my fingers out of the way of the blade and slice long ways. And I think that's about enough. I don't think I can get another one in there. And then swivel it around and then chop downward. A tomato, that will be going in later in the recipe, but it's better to get the knife work out of the way. So we have this nice tomato, and I'm just going to cut it down the center. That gives me 2/2 to work with. And the slicing here is just like what we did with the onion to get our fine dices or medium dices that we have. So I'm going to start close to the bottom and I'm going to slice through almost to the edge, but not quite. And continue until we're pretty much toward the top. Turn it a little and then slice downward. Watching fingers, these are very sharp knives and they work really well. They're a pleasure to use, actually, knowing that when I press down, a cut will be made. And then swivel and chop. This tomato is huge, so I'm probably just going to use this half. So if you have a medium-sized tomato that you can chop, that's perfect. And I don't peel them and I don't remove the seeds. I just go ahead and chop them. So now we're ready to get back to our chorizo. Here I am with the chorizo and I've brought it back to the counter and you can see how much grease. Part of that was olive oil that I used to brown the sausage, but I like to take any excess oil out. You can leave it in if you want to, but for me, it comes out. Now we put our chopped half onion in, as well as our chopped jalapeno pepper. And then we add some spices. I have a half tablespoon, the same as 1 1/2 teaspoons of dried oregano. And I have 1 1/2 tablespoon of chili powder. I also have 1 1/2 tablespoon of garlic powder. I'm not adding salt because the chorizo will be salty enough. And this goes to the stove and we cook until our vegetables are tender. After about 5 minutes, the onion and the jalapeno pepper will be softened and your mixture looks like this. So it's time to add our chopped tomato. And then we're also adding beans. These are pinto beans. They're from a can. It's a 15-ounce can with the liquid. We're also adding 3/4 cup water. So everything is cooled down, so I'm going to turn that up a little, bring it to a boil, and then we will let it simmer for about 20 minutes or so, and we'll have some lovely ranch beans. Our ranch beans have simmered for 20 minutes. They look luscious. You can see that the simmering has thickened up the juice a little. If it's not enough for you, then just simmer longer. And also, you'll see that this is a small amount of ranch beans for what I'm serving it in. So if you have a situation like this and you have a lot of people to feed, just double the recipe. And I've chosen to serve it with corn sticks. These are cornbread sticks. And I have butter that has kind of melted on the top because those are nice and hot. They'll be delicious with ranch beans. And I've chosen a cold beer. Rick will probably have this with his serving. I thought it would look good and that a lot of you would enjoy that taste. I'm going to taste the ranch beans and let you know what I think about them. Those flavors are good together. Really good. This is really great. It's something that is almost unexpected because these look plain enough, but when you put that in your mouth, it is just alive with flavor. It's very spicy, very nice. I think you'll love it.